So a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. I am Manish Mishra, and in today's session, guys, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And remember, guys, these sessions are helpful for the ESI current affairs. For the static part, you have to study more things. All right. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions and also regarding the courses. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with regard to Atmanirbhar Krishi app, and you have to identify the correct statements out of these three statements. So let's talk about this news. So remember, the Atmanirbhar Krishi app has been launched by the Office of Principal Scientific Advisor. Now, who is the principal scientific advisor to the Government of India? It's Mr. K. Vijay Raghavan. Remember this, Professor K. Vijay Raghavan is the principal scientific advisor to the Government of India. Also remember that this app has been launched under the Kisan Mitra Initiative. Kisan Mitra Initiative hai, Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor ka, uske under is app ko launch kiya gaya hai. And what is this Kisan Mitra initiative? So first of all, do remember that this initiative is of the Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor. And the basic objective of this initiative is to give insights to the farmers, is to give insights and recommendations to the farmers based on the data provided by the different government departments. Like for example, IMD ne agar koi data diya, ya Ministry of Environment ne koi data diya, to wo data ke through farmers ko insights di jati hai so that they can improve their crop production, right? Now, this app has been created to equip farmers with actionable agricultural insights and early weather alerts. So, in this app ke through, kisano ko jo agricultural insights hai, wo milengi, aur iske alawa early weather alerts bhi di jayengi. Okay? And of course, ye jo alert honge, ye jo insights honge, that will be provided by the various departments of the Government of India. Because Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor will not go and collect the data and then provide to the farmers. Aisa nahi hoga. The data will be collected from various government departments. It will be uploaded in the app and then can be used by the farmers, right? So the sources of information would be various departments, as I said, IMD, ISRO, NWIC and others, and these departments will make the data available to the farmers. Remember that the Tech Mahindra Makers Lab team has designed and built this app, which is known as Atmanirbhar Krishi app, right? Now, what will be the working process of the app? So remember, the app does not collect any inputs from the farmer. Farmer se koi input nahi liya jayega. All the inputs will be provided by the various departments of the government, and that input will be used by the farmers to enhance their crop production. Okay. And data related to soil type, soil health, moisture, weather and water table, all these type of data will be provided through this app. And also remember that the app is currently available in 12 languages. 12 languages mein ye app abhi available hogi, and in future more languages will be added to the app, alright. So that was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. It is launched by the Office of Principal Scientific Advisor. Yes, absolutely correct. It is launched under the Kisan Mitra Initiative. Yes, is that correct? Absolutely correct. Tech Mahindra Makers Lab team has designed this app. This is also correct, which means all are correct, should be the correct answer, option D. Option D should be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number two. Question number two says, to promote the ease of doing business and to improve the contract enforcement regime in our country. Now, what is this contract enforcement? We will talk about this later. So to improve this contract enforcement regime in our country, enforcing contracts portal has been launched by which ministry? Kaun si ministry ne isko launch kiya hai? The question is this, okay? So let's talk about this. Remember, the Ministry of Law and Justice, which is headed by Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. Ravi Shankar Prasad is the Minister of Law in our country, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Patna, which is of course the capital of Bihar. So this ministry has launched Enforcing Contracts Portal. Now this has been done to promote ease of doing business and to improve the contract enforcement regime in the country. Hamare desh ka jo contract enforcement regime hai, usko improve karne ke liye, this Enforcing Contracts Portal has been launched. There will be a website which is doj.gov.in/eodb, that is envisioned to be a comprehensive source of information, which means that this website will be a source of information related to the legislative and policy reforms which are being undertaken on the enforcing contracts parameters. नाउ एनफोर्सिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्ट की अगर हम बात करें, सो रिमेंबर दिस इज वन ऑफ द पैरामीटर्स इन द डूइंग बिजनेस रिपोर्ट, जो ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस रिपोर्ट होती है वर्ल्ड बैंक की, ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस रिपोर्ट, इट इज़ वन ऑफ द इंडिकेटर ऑफ द ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस रिपोर्ट, जिसमें यह होता है कि कितनी जल्दी कमर्शियल डिस्प्यूट जो है वो सॉल्व हो रहे हैं किसी पर्टिकुलर कंट्री में. इसका मतलब होता है, ये मतलब होता है इन्फोर्सिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स का. ओके, हाउ फास्ट द कमर्शियल डिस्प्यूट्स आर बीइंग रिजॉल्व्ड इन अ कंट्री इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इन्फोर्सिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड इट इज़ वन ऑफ द पैरामीटर्स. एंड इफ इन अ कंट्री द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ डिस्प्यूट इज फास्टर देन दैट कंट्री इज प्रमोटिंग दैट देन दैट यू कैन से दैट दैट कंट्री इज गुड इन द टर्म्स ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस. ओके, so the portal will provide easy access to latest information on commercial cases in dedicated commercial courts of Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore and Kolkata. Okay, and this portal also will host online reporting by all high courts regarding the mediation and arbitration centers. And as I told you, the enforcing contracts, it is an indicator under the ease of doing business report of the World Bank. It is that essential area that measures time and cost to resolve a standardized commercial dispute as well as a series of good practices in the judiciary. मतलब कितनी जल्दी कोई भी commercial dispute resolve होता है किस country में, इस enforcing contract indicator से हमें पता चलता है. And to remove this regime, improve this regime, यानी कि जो commercial disputes है उनको जल्दी से जल्दी निपटारा करने के लिए, उनको जल्दी से जल्दी resolve करने के लिए this portal has been launched. Right? And this will definitely in turn promote the ease of doing business. So this has been launched by the Ministry of Law and Justice. The very easy question, option A, will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. So given below are some highlights of UDI SE Plus 2019-20. So you have to identify the correct statement and you have to pick out the correct set out of the options. In which ko jo bhi correct set hai wo aapko identify karna hai. All right. So UDIC plus, what is this UDIC plus then? It is United Information System on Education plus. Okay, so this, remember, it is a management information system. It is basically a management information system which collects data related to the school education. ये एक management information system है जो कि school की details से related data collect करता है and then उसको analyze करने का काम किया जाता है by the Ministry of Education. Remember UDI SI Plus, it was launched in 2018-19 and it is an advanced version of the UDI SE which was launched in the financial year 2012-13. All right. So this is about UDI SE. It is basically, remember that it is a management information system which collects data regarding the school details. Now let's talk about the report that has been presented by UDSI Plus regarding the school education. So the report says that in the year 2019-20, total students in the school education from pre-primary to higher secondary, pre-primary se leke higher secondary tak ki baat hui hai isme, have crossed 26.45 crores. 26.45 crore students stay from pre-primary to higher secondary. This is higher by 42.3 lakh compared to the year 2018-19, the previous financial year. If we talk about the 2020-19-20, uske pichle financial year mein 42.3 lakh kam tha. Pupil-teacher ratio has been improved in all the levels from pre-primary to higher secondary. And remember, in the financial year 2020, there were 96.87 lakh teachers who were engaged in the school education, and this is about 2.57 lakh higher as compared to the year 2018-19, which means there are less students per teacher now. Okay, jo pupil teacher ratio hai wo improve ho raha hai. Gross enrollment ratio ki baat kar lo, so gross enrollment ratio at all levels of schools has improved. In the year 2019-20, if you talk about the previous financial year of 2018-19, so remember, in the upper primary level, the GER has been increased to 89.7% from the 87.7% which was in the year 2018-19. In the elementary level, it has been increased to 97.8% from 96.1%. In the secondary level, it has been increased to 77.9% from 76.9%. 1% ka increase hai, but still there is an increase. In higher secondary level ka increase hua hai to 51.4% from 50.1%. And don't confuse this gross enrollment ratio with that provided by All India higher secondary education wala jo report aaya tha. Okay, uske according 27.1% was the gross enrollment ratio, overall gross enrollment ratio in the higher education. Okay, so don't confuse these two, gross enrollment ratio. Now talking about the enrollment of Divyang students, so it has been increased by 6.52% over the period of 2018-19, and enrollment of girls may bhi kaafi acha improvement aaya hai. It has from primary to higher secondary, jo enrollment of girls hai, that is more than 12.08 crores, which is an increase of 14.08 lakh if we talk about the previous financial year of 2019. Alright. Gender parity index may be improvement hai kaafi at both the secondary and higher secondary levels. And remember, gender parity index ke liye jo bahut sara data is report pe given hai, that is not important for the exam. Don't go and mug up that thing. Okay. Improvement of gender parity index has been most pronounced at the higher secondary level. This is important. The improvement in GPI, gender parity index, sabse zyada kahan pe dikhi hai? Higher secondary level pe, which has gone up to 1.04 in 2019-20, which was 0.97 in the year 2012-13. 2012-13 mein jo ki kitna tha? 0.97 tha, jo ki badh ke kitna ho gaya hai? 1.04. Now this report also talks about the facilities which are provided in the schools. जो जो facility provide हो रही है उसकी भी बात करता है। So electricity की बात करें तो more than 80% of schools in India now in the year 2019-20 had the functional electricity. And thanks to the PM Saubhagya Yojana for this. PM Saubhagya Yojana में बिजली दी जा रही है। And this is an improvement of more than 6% over the previous year 2018-19. Computers, the number of schools having functional computers increased to 5.2 lakh in the year 2019-20 from the earlier 4.7 lakh. Thoda sa increment hai, but yes, hai to sahi. Internet ki baat kar lo, that's very important thing. Aaj ki date mein bahut zyada zaruri ho gaya internet. The number of schools having internet facilities has been increased to 3.36 lakh in the year 2019-20 to 2.9 lakh in the year 2018-19, and thanks to the BharatNet project. भारत नेट प्रोजेक्ट है, हम सबको पता है, फाइबर बिछाए जा रहे हैं इंटरनेट के, इसमें तो ऑब्वियसली इंटरनेट का जो रीच है वो हमारे देश में बढ़ रहा है. हैंड वॉश फैसिलिटी इन मोर देन 90% ऑफ द स्कूल इन इंडिया हैड द हैंड वॉश फैसिलिटी इन द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2019-20, एंड फॉर दिस लेट्स थैंक्स टू द स्वच्छ भारत मिशन. मेडिकल चेकअप्स, मोर देन 82% ऑफ स्कूल्स कंडक्टेड मेडिकल चेकअप्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स इन द ईयर 2019-20, विच इज एन इंक्रीज ऑफ मोर देन 4%. 4% से ज़्यादा का इंक्रीज है, सो विच इज़ यू नो अ गुड इंक्रीमेंट. एक ही साल का अंतर है, 2018-19 में था, अब 2019-20 की बात करें तो एक साल में अगर 4% की इंक्रीमेंट है, 4% का ग्रोथ है, देन दैट इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ गुड ग्रोथ. ओके, लाइब्रेरी रीडिंग रूम, मोर देन 84% स्कूल्स इन इंडिया हैड अ लाइब्रेरी और रीडिंग रूम और द रीडिंग कॉर्नर इन द ईयर 2019-20, जबकि 2012-13 में इट वॉज 69.2% ओनली, बट नाउ इट हैज़ बीन इंक्रीज टू 84%. So that is a huge increment. So guys, this was about this report, and now let's come back to the question. You have to find out the accurate set of the options. Okay, so total students in school education from pre-primary to higher secondary have crossed 26.45 crores. This is absolutely correct. Gross enrollment ratio at all levels of school education has reduced. No, it in fact has increased. So this statement is incorrect. In 2019-20, 2.57 lakh more teachers as compared to 2018-19 were engaged in school education. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And enrollment of Divyang students has decreased. No, it has been increased. Decreased, sorry, na hua hai, increase hua hai. So this statement is incorrect, which means we have first statement which is correct, second incorrect, third correct, and once again four incorrect. So the correct set of options should be option B. 2 and 4 are incorrect, should be the correct answer to this question. And now guys, let's move ahead to question number 4, which is about the project BOLD, and it is once again about the bamboo, and we all know bamboo is also known as what? Green gold. So what is the main objective of the project BOLD that was launched by KVIC? Remember, KVIC chairperson is Mr. Vinay Kumar Saxena, and KVIC is headquartered in New Delhi mein iska headquarter hai, do remember this. Now talking about the project BOLD, so BOLD has a full form also. BOLD ke ek full form bhi hai, Bamboo Oasis on Lands in Drought. Ab iske naam se pata chal raha hai ki hum kya karne wale hain isme. Jo aise areas hain, jo desert areas hain, jo arid areas hain aur jo semi areas hain, we are going to grow bamboo in those areas of arid and semi arid regions. So Bamboo Oasis on Lands in Drought is the full form of Project Bold, and it has been launched from the village Nichla Mandwa, which is in Udaipur in Rajasthan. Udaipur, Rajasthan mein village hai jiska naam hai Nichla Mandwa. Wahan se is project ko launch kiya gaya hai. And also remember that it has been launched at a part of KVIC's Khadi Bamboo Festival to celebrate 75 years of independence of India, that is Azadi ka Amrit Mahotsav. Also remember that, as I told you, that it has been launched to create bamboo based green patches in arid and semi arid land zones. Arid means desert places, and semi arid zones are those which are not as dry as desert and not as wet as the mangrove region. Okay, so beach ka ilaka hota hai semi arid wala. And what will happen under this project? So under this project, already they have planted 5000 saplings of special bamboo species, which are Bambusa tulda and Bambusa polymorpha from Assam. And these have been planted over 60 acres of vacant arid gram panchayat land of village Nichla Mandwa. ये जो दो species है bamboo के, ये कहाँ से लाए गए हैं? असम से लाए गए हैं, और इनको राजस्थान में इसका जो है वो इसको grow किया जाएगा. Okay? And also remember, this was a world record of planting the highest number of bamboo saplings in a day. सबसे ज़्यादा bamboo saplings लगाने का ये world record भी बनाया है KVIC ने. So now let's come back to the question. What is the main objective? Providing financial assistance? No. Promoting the sale and marketing of KVIC? No. Promoting research in the village industry sector? No. To create bamboo based green patches in arid and semi arid zone? Option D will be the correct answer. Right? Kyunki isme kya hoga? Bamboo based green patches banaye jayenge in the arid and semi arid zones. And now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Nipun Bharat program. You have to identify the incorrect statement regarding the Nipun Bharat program. Remember, Nipun in English means skillful. Skillful, or you can say skilled. Okay, so Nipun Bharat means skillful India program or skilled India program. So now, remember, this Nipun Bharat program has been launched by Ministry of Education, which is headed by Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. And his Lok Sabha constituency is Haridwar, which is of course in Uttarakhand. So they have launched Nipun Bharat program, and do remember there is a full form of Nipun also. Nipun ka ek full form bhi hai, which is National Initiative for Proficiency in Reading with Understanding and Numeracy. National Initiative for Proficiency in Reading with Understanding and Numeracy. So iske naam se iska jo full form hai usse pata chal raha hai ki kya hai scheme. So it has been launched to cover the learning needs of children in the age group of 3 to 9 years preschool up to the class 3. And remember, it has been launched as a part of the National Education Policy 2020. Now, if you talk about the broader objective, so the broader objective of this mission is to create an enabling environment to ensure universal acquisition of the foundation literacy and numeracy. Matlab, thoda bahut bhi student jo hai wo padh paaye aur jo numbers ka hai unko knowledge ho, basic knowledge. By focusing that, now this will be done by focusing that every child achieve the desired learning competencies in reading, writing and numeracy. Basically, teen cheezo pe focus hoga. The reading skills, the writing skills and the numeracy skills by the end of grade 3, unko ye teenon cheeze aani chahiye, and this has to be achieved by the year 2026-27, or you can say the financial year 2027. And remember, a 5-tier implementation mechanism will be set up at the national, state, district, block and school level. 5 tier ki implementation level hogi, national level pe, state level pe, district pe, block pe aur school pe. In all the states and UTs under the aegis of Centrally Sponsored Scheme of Samagra Shiksha Abhiyan. I hope you all remember the Samagra Shiksha Abhiyan. Samagra Shiksha Abhiyan hai, uske antargat isme 5-tier implementation ke through isko implement kiya jayega. Now the focus will be on providing access and retaining children in foundational years of schooling, teacher capacity building, development of high quality and diversified student and teacher resources or the learning materials, and tracking the progress of each child in achieving learning outcomes. So this is not important for the exam. This is just for the basic understanding that what will be the focus of this program. The main thing, the main important thing in this scheme is the full form, the ministry and the basic objective, and up to when this has to be achieved. All right. Aur ye kaun se scheme ke under implement hua hai. That is it. Isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. So now let's come back to the question. Not correct statement find karna hai. Nipun stands for National Initiative for Proficiency in Reading with Understanding and Numeracy. Absolutely correct. It is in line with the National Education Policy 2020. Again, correct. It aims to cover the learning needs of children in the age group of 3 to 12 years. No, that's from the age group of 3 to 9 years, not 3 to 12 years. So this option C will be the correct answer. Option C, guys, will be the correct answer, but let's read out the other options also. It aims to achieve desired learning outcomes by the end of grade 3 by 26-27. Yes, correct. And it is under the aegis of central sponsored scheme of Swamagra Shiksha. This is also correct. So option C, guys, here is the correct answer. And that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.